Saddle up your horses. Listen to this a little bit. Stephen Curtis Chapman. Hey man, this is Missy Hood, and how's everybody doing? This is Tame Your Brain Now. That was Stephen Curtis Chapman. It's one of the first albums, Christian albums, I got. When I started getting introduced to Christian music about 25 years ago, it's one of my favorite songs. It's called The Great Adventure. Your walk's supposed to be an adventure. Here, let me cut this down so I can focus on what I'm saying to you. Although I want to listen to that. Your walk is supposed to be an adventure. All walks are supposed to be an adventure. So, the reason I'm coming to you today is that I have a prophetic word for you. And it's called Living Keys. Living Keys. I had a vision this morning. I got into praise and high praise, and I didn't understand how God was going to use it, but I think before I tell you this too, I probably need to pray with you, so make sure we bind the enemy away for distractions and things like that. So let's pray first before we start. So Father God, I just thank you for today, Lord. I invite you here, Lord. This is your time. This is where you meet me, Lord God, to speak to your people. And Father, first of all, Father, we take authority over any unclean spirit, any distraction. Anything that, because I didn't go into the studio today, Father God, and so we bind up all distractions, Father, with Luke 10:19. And I bind up any sniffling and things like that, Father, and with my allergies only seem to kick in when I'm trying to do these things. And so I bind those things away, Lord. I bind up the enemy's head, his hands, his feet, and his mouth with Luke 10:19. Bind its armor and its weapons, Father, Lord. We strip off the armor and the weapons with 2 Samuel 2:21 and Exodus 15:6. Lord, we just release, Father, your hand, Lord, just to sever the heads off of all these demons, Father. And we release freedom. Father, you said, whom the sun sets free is free indeed, Lord. And you, Lord, you said, your sheep know your voice, and they only follow after you, Lord. Use my vessel right now to speak to your people. Let it be a right now word, Lord. I sense it's for leaders and for the followers, Father, but a lot of it's like half and half. And so, Lord, gauge my words right now. Use my mind, will, and emotions. Let it be orderly. Let it be a timely word, but let it be encouraging, Lord God. I thank you. Thank you, thank you, Lord. We're saddling up our horses. We're getting ready to mark our trails, Father, and go into the great unknown. I bless you. Amen. So, I'm driving down the road this morning. I took my mom to the doctor. We got a great bill of health. Today's been a good day all the way around so far. We got her released. My mom and I didn't know if any of you knew about this, though, but my mom and I are both intercessors. We're high-level intercessors, and so we both took really bad hits last year. Me twice, but hers was almost three times as bad, in that she almost died in a car accident. And I had gotten my ribs broken twice last year. The last time was the worst, which was in December when I was trying to hang Christmas lights in the tree, and it was just a fluke. It was the devil, where I stepped out and I didn't have enough upper arm strength to hold onto the limb, and I fell down 6 feet and hit my side onto a rock wall, and so I cracked 6 of my ribs. And so we've been on the mend, and so today we took her to the doctor for her final checkup. She got released. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So and I really mean that, because I've been really gauging that and diligently working with her so that she could get healing and get back on her feet. And so that's been my goal for like the last 8 months. And she was bedridden for 5 months of that. So this has been a blessing already today. So I'm driving down, taking her to this doctor's appointment. And we put on Chris Tomlin, which I love Chris Tomlin. So I'm always listening to him or somebody. I love Stephen Curtis Chapman, different people like Rick Pino. These are great ways to get up in the spirit. These are great artists. And so, right away, the Holy Spirit starts bringing me into the throne room, and I recognize the power of His Spirit. I thought, whoa, He wants to talk to me today. Cool. Let's listen. So I had a vision, and I saw a lock on a door. It was an old-timey lock, and I saw myself. I really wasn't sure who was at first until after the door opened, but it was inserted into the lock like a key, and it turned. The key turned, and the door opened, and I was standing before this vastness of blue sky, and it was like just the sky's the limit kind of an attitude. And I'm looking down, and then all of a sudden I see myself fall out of the door, tumbling down. And then at first it was tumbling, and this is key, listen to this, the momentum felt like I was out of control. And then it was almost like a really experienced skydiver, a novice, where I gained control and I was controlling my atmospheres, being able to keep myself flat, stomach down, being able to come down for a very nice firm landing. And then I was in, the vision turned into and transcended into me being surrounded by trees, tree stumps. Some of them were just stumps, others were full-blown trees, but they were all around me. And I was looking over to my right, but I'm dancing out here in the rain. And it wasn't just any kind of rain. And this is for many of you, by the way. You're dancing in the rain right now with a lot of trees around you. Trees represent people, onlookers. So, but this is not to be grotesque. The Lord gave me that word very strategically. It's what it is in the spirit right now. But it was raining blood all over us, the blood of Jesus. We're dancing in the rain, just dancing in His spirit, dancing in the love, just dancing and having a great time. Wow. Forgive me. Why that is so important is that many of us have gone through so much hell. I mean, nobody has any idea. And forgive me. Get composed. Nobody has any idea that what the new leaders have gone through. And I'm not trying to make anybody feel sorry for us or anybody. Not at all. I obey the Lord. I chose to walk in this place. And so have many of you, where we have gone through more than the average Joe. Some are called to be officers in the kingdom of heaven, where others are called to be citizens of heaven. And for the officers, the anointing has to be built. It has to be built, and it's built through a lot of pain. And so the onlookers represent, to my right, I saw these stumps of trees, and they didn't have treetops, which meant there was no growth. They'd been chopped off. And I knew that represented people in my past. And this is for you, who had deeply wounded me, who had been used by the devil to cause deep wounds in my heart, in deep places where I've just been enraged at the injustices that have been caused. And so have many of you. You've gone through a lot of injustices, a lot of pain to build the anointing. But like my mentor, I'm going to get back to the vision in a second. That's not through yet. My mentor told me, and it was totally the Lord. She made it a point to tell me, I've been praying with one of my mentors, and she's also a prayer partner for almost 20 years now. And she said, Missy, don't forget, this is all a tool for refining you. And you're going to get into that place. And so are many of you of destiny here really quick now, to where you're going to look back on these times and you're going to think, thank you, Jesus. You know, thank you for putting me through that, because it's made us who we are today. But a lot of people have no idea that what the new leadership has gone through to be used as these living keys for this hour. So before I go further into that, because there's a lot more to that word, let's go back to the trees. So you've been wounded by this. There's a group of people who are stuck. They've chosen to stay stuck, and they're looking at you. And a lot of them are kind of dazed right now, because a lot of us have walked away from those relationships, and we're choosing to. We will not be abused anymore. We will not be mistreated or disrespected anymore. We will not tolerate the bad behavior patterns of these Christians. A lot of them are Christians who have chosen to stay stuck, chosen to stay in selfish behavior patterns. And I'll mark the selfish, because it is selfish. Ish. It's not Christ-based. Love is always others oriented. It's never about me. And so when we're focused on others and making sure that we're respecting boundaries, making sure that we're looking out for other people, making sure everybody's taken care of, that's the heart of a leader. That's the heart of a true leader. When you're always taking care of the sheep. And not everybody's called to be a leader, but we are called to be respectful individuals of one another, whether you're a believer or unbeliever. So I then looked at the trees and I saw Jesus plow through and break him in half. Just moved him out of the way. And he started dancing with me in the rain. Just dancing and dancing and dancing with me in the rain. And then I saw myself, and this isn't for everybody, but this is for me and certain leaders. This part is strictly for leadership. I started seeing international flags around me with clear blue skies. And then I heard as clear as day while I'm driving, the Lord said, things are fixing to get so good for you. So good for you. And he goes, your latter will be greater than your former. You're fixing to walk in wealth transfer like you've never known before. Whew, I'm getting the presence. And the Lord says that I'm fixing to make you a very wealthy woman, Missy. And that's for many of you. So then that was the vision part of it. Well, then coming home, the Lord continued to expound to me. And there were two other things he wanted me to warn believers about, singles and married people, but especially the married people. Well, it's just the equivalent. The urgency of it is the equivalent for both, because there are spirits operating on Christians and especially non-Christians in this hour. And I've experienced it as a single person where it's going to come, try to come and defile you. It's going to try to disqualify you. And it's done through Jezebel and Ahab, by the way. Jezebel is the mother of religion. She's also the mother of perversity, as is Ahab. Ahab just uses Jezebel to do its dirty work. It's really the one conniving behind the scenes. It's Jezebel is the aggressive controller. The Ahab spirit's the passive controller. And it indirectly tries to control and manipulate so it can never be found out. And neither spirit wants to be found out. It tries to cloak itself at all costs. And so, but these two spirits have really operate in a spirit of perversity along with it, with witchcraft, okay? And the more entrenched, the longer a person has been entrenched in that spirit, that means that spirit's going to be very strong in that vessel that comes against you, especially if you're a prophet. And so I want to use myself as an example, and then I also want to go into another thing for married people. It's very hard for me as a single woman to be around, and it's not hard for me personally. I don't have a problem with lusting after people, things like that. I don't feel like I do. But I do, you know, I have natural inclinations where I want to be loved by a man. I want to get married. And we all do as single people. And so most do. But I had an incident happen about, I want to say 10 years ago. Well, I'd never experienced it before, where a spirit was so strong on a man, a married man, by the way, a married man, where I was working underneath him. And I'm really like a child. I have a very childlike heart when I interact with men or even some women, where and that's what allows me to get into the things of the spirit so easily, because I just believe in, I just trust God, and we're off, we're doing our thing. But people usually mistake that for stupidity or naivety, usually naivety, like I'm not educated or that I don't know better and I can be taken advantage of and manipulated easily. So in walks Ahab, major spirit of lust on this person, and the spirit was so strong. I had never experienced an all-consuming fire like that. And at first, and I'm being honest here, this is what happened to me. And God protected me. He really protected me. But the person was almost like stalker in a sense, to where they would always show up at my desk. I'd turn around and they'd be there. They'd be there. Hi, how you doing, Missy? Blah, 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 blah. And I'm starting to kind of, and at first I didn't even know what was going on, because I'm just oblivious, because I was busy trying to learn a new job. But then it became very apparent what his intentions were, and his own wife is even picking up on it. And I'm just like, I just work here. I just freaking work here. And it almost became a joke to me, although I knew it wasn't a joke spiritually, because I had no idea until now the ramifications of what God was protecting me from. So long story short, his assistant falsely accused me of trying to have an affair with this person. I was like, you're crazy. You're absolutely crazy. And she had a drinking problem and a lot of other issues. And I'm not judging. That's what was going on in my atmosphere then. And so I confronted her on that, because I was dealing with Jezebel and her. He was Ahab. She was Jezebel. So they were perfectly paired. And his wife probably operated in it too. But long story short, I ended up getting fired for confronting the secretary. And it was the best thing that could have ever happened to me, because it protected me. It was Christ protecting me from falling and from losing the anointing. So you have to listen to me on this. That's for the singles. this next statement is going to be for the married people, especially if you're in leadership and you're in the public eye. I'm seeing more dysfunctional Christians now than I'm astounded by some of the crap I'm seeing. I'm not lying to you at all. And I am going to judge that. I'm going to judge that through Exodus 6:6 and let the Lord be the judge of that, because I have a mantle of Deborah on my life. And so my call personally is to be a Joseph to the Pharaohs and to protect leadership. God has always used me like that, to come up around leadership and to guard them, be a gatekeeper, protect them. And I see some of the most, it's like desperation from some people. They're either in loveless marriages or they're not married yet. So they're following after these leaders when the leaders' hearts are really pure towards these people. And then some of them are spirit-filled to where they start praying in tongues for that relationship, for the person to leave their spouse and come to that person who's lusting after them. It's a spirit of lust, which is, i.e., another spirit of Jezebel. So it's witchcraft being released against that leader to try to bring in that downfall where they're disqualified, they lose the anointing. And then, by the way, the same thing happened to Catherine Kuhlman. And I loved Catherine Kuhlman. She was a highly, highly anointed woman of God. Still love listening to her today. But she was a single woman for years and years too, because God had established her as a high-level leader for anointing as of healing. She had a major, pardon me, healing calling. And she operated in the signs, wonders, and the miracles, but she grew lonely. She ended up having an affair and getting married. Ended up, the man divorced his wife. I'm pretty sure that's pretty much how the story goes. And she lost the anointing. And so, she didn't lose the gifting, but it really took a hit. The anointing took a hit. And so, there have been other leaders that have fallen from grace like that in this hour. And a lot of people would cringe at this conversation, but you know what? I don't care. I don't care. These are things that the church needs to be talking about. And we're not prepared because everybody's afraid to touch hot button issues. Welcome to my world. I'm not. I'm right here. Jesus is here to set you free, so you'll be free indeed. Because we're working in an hour right now where the enemy's working overtime to disqualify many of the saints. And you want to know why? Thank you, Jesus. We're right on time with the next part of this conversation. It's because the witches and the Satanists in our areas, not only do we have to combat the devil and demons over our regions, we have to combat the enemy's army, which are unbelievers or people who have purposely got into his army through Satanism and witchcraft. So they're practicing witches and Satanists in our region. Hello, my region houses the most Satanists and witches in the nation. Woohoo! Hallelujah! I've always wondered why God left me in this region. So I've got the hardest region to war in, more so than even D.C., more so. And what happens at the head will trickle down like the oil in the beard of Aaron. So Jezebel is working overtime to get into office so that she can make the whole nation bitter and spread herself through her bitter words, through announcements, through video and news reels of that leader being in office. Because its words, on its words are the anointing. So it's trying to spread bitter roots and bitter fruits to make the whole nation molded into an antichrist spirit instead of into Jesus Christ like we once were. This is why we have to get an anointed person for Christ into office. This is why. So the witches and Satanists know a lot of them are really ahead of the eight ball, but the body of Christ now, we're like right here. Okay, we've just gotten, thank you Jesus for showing me that too. God just showed me that. Because I thought we were like right here, but we're really right here. So we're up above the witchcraft now. We're ahead of the eight ball, finally. Again, we were like that about 10 years ago, and then they got ahead of us for some, I think, I don't know what they did. Well, I do know what they did, actually. They're going into the things of the Spirit, and they go down into the pits of hell, and they have rooms in the pits of hell where they get keys. Oh my gosh, I'm learning while I'm talking. These keys can be living keys that are people, just like in our kingdom, we're a living key. We're living keys. Some of us are living keys for our hour that we live in. And God puts us into locks to unlock the door so that all the saints can walk through because of the pioneering spirit in our life. So God's no respecter of persons. What he does for one, he does for all. And so he's letting, we're helping to pioneer a way for multiple people to come in. So they go down into the pits of hell. they get these keys for the future, but they're going after future generations. The Lord showed me that today. They're trying to get keys, living keys that will lock doors against our future generations of Christians. So the next generation can't get up into position. That's what's been holding back our generations up until now, because we didn't know what we were warring against. Now we do. Now we do. So we need to be going up into the third heavens and asking for keys. Who are those keys? Who? Not what. Who are those keys? Have them cross my path. Connect them. Get us rightly connected for this season and this hour. And start unlocking the doors so that the multitudes can come in. That's what's going to create this end time harvest that everybody's been talking about. This revival that everybody's been talking about. Are you pumped up? I am so pumped up right now. Now I can't sleep. But I don't need you because it's like mid-afternoon. That's a dumb thing to say. So anyway, I'm going to get about my day. I wanted to leave you with that. Wanted to make sure that each one of you know you're being prayed for. I do pray for people who are on my podcast, who follow me on Twitter, as well as on Facebook. I pray for my leaders. Make sure you're praying for your leaders. They need all the help. We need all the help we can get, actually. And I am not as high up as some of them are in this hour. And a lot of us are in transition. We've been talking about that. You need to be staying rightly connected so you can be staying on the up and up with the prophetic word as you move forward into your destiny and future. And educate yourself. Educate yourself. Get free from generational cursings that are holding you back. Continue to get free. If you get free, it'll catapult you up into destiny. It'll catapult you up in the spirit. So you'll be that much closer to where you want to be, doing what you love to do and not what you have to do. Know that I love you. Praying for you. And I'll catch up with you soon. Love you. Bye-bye.